We've known Sarah and her partner at Design by Them, Nick, for a few years now, having worked closely on designEX with them and other events. Sarah's passion for business has been vital to the success of Design by Them. If she is not designing products or developing marketing channels to support and promote the work of Australian designers, Sarah is leading the inter-office bake-off, the results of which you can see in their monthly newsletter. We're yet to do the Design by Them designEX bake-off. But that's coming. The collaborative nature of Design by Them has enabled them to work with clients such as Oriton and Dion Lee. Please join me in welcoming Sarah Gibson.
So over the past couple of weeks, I don't know if any of you have been to the Gallery of New South Wales, but there's an exhibition on at the moment called Sydney Modern, and the poster for the exhibition is a painting of the Opera House, painted by Grace Cottingley Smith, and it was painted in the 1930s, and every time I see it, I think, God, how amazing is that, that in the 1930s someone had this vision. The Harbour Bridge, in a time where, you know, people were perhaps riding a horse to work, that one day we'd have a harbour bridge that would have 8 lanes and support 2 train lines. And this got me thinking about design and why that's such a good design. I think it's just got such amazing foresight. And then I started thinking about how that applies to what I do. I'm not sure if my sketch is really sure work in a good way, but to me, it really is the foresight in our design is to design products that are sustainable. You know, how do you design products that think about the needs of now, but also considering the needs of our future? So that is important to me as a designer. You know, we live in a world where we can't need 1.5 worlds to support our current lifestyle. And that's because we keep using too much materials and energy, and they're not renewable. And so if you